Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Big Yak Monthly Cup. It is the first edition of October 2024 taking place today. New edition, of course, means new prizes this month. Special edition in terms of maps, which is very interesting. And other than that, working the same way as usual. So maybe first of all, let's talk about the maps. Because usually, and with usually I mean the previous 2 months, I used maps that I randomized on Trackmania Exchange. So basically randomized out of the entire map pool uploaded to Trackmania Exchange. But this time, we have brand new maps because I asked you guys in the chat for maps. All of you guys had the chance to submit maps for this tournament, and those will be used for the entire month. So we have maps built by you guys which are dank, which are really good, which are partly really bad. We have literally everything. All of the maps unknown, not released to public. Nobody knows them besides me, basically, because I tested them and the mapper who built them. And it's going to be very interesting to see them now in a tournament with over 100 players and how they are going to learn the maps. Format-wise, it's going to be the same as always. We have 15 maps. On each map, we have one warm-up and then 3 live rounds. In each of the live rounds, players can collect points. And at some point, they will reach the point limit of 6,969. And yeah, once they hit the point limit, they are in finalist mode, which means they need to win one more round in order to close it out. And that is pretty much all you need to know. Very standard Trackmania format. So I hope you guys are ready. We have 107 players on server 1 alone. Server 2, probably quite a few players as well. So very stacked edition today. We have a lot of strong players. And I would say, Mr. John C, start the match. We are ready. Servers are ready. Players are ready. Let's freaking go. Good luck, have fun to all of the gamers. And we are gonna hop straight to map number 1. Built by one of you guys in the chat. It's gonna be really, really cool. You guys can still join the server as well. Not server 1 because it's full, but server 2 and 3 you should be able to join. You can find them in my club, Granadi's Wheelhood. And the very first map is called Dirt Mix, built by Vkrantz. Vkrantz, quite a regular viewer of mine, quite often in the chat. And this is actually a pretty normal map, if I remember correctly. As you can see, a dirt map. And that maybe brings me to the point where I can explain a little bit more of what maps you can expect. Because it can be pretty much anything. Because the only requirements for the maps were that they must be drivable in this format. They must be somewhat understandable, like easy to understand in rounds. And they had to be between 20 and 50 seconds long. But style-wise and difficulty-wise, if it's, you know, moderate, it could have been pretty much anything. Okay, people, oh my god, people had a very long loading time. Holy shit, people are just loading in now. What the hell? Okay, that's crazy. People had a very long loading time. I hope server is not wrong. Question mark emoji. I hope everything is gonna be fine. That's a bit scary. I mean, 110 players on the server is, of course, quite a lot. So that sucks now a little bit for the warm-up, but yeah, no? I hope it's gonna be fine. As long as the server is not crashing, it's gonna be fine. I really hope it's not gonna. But map 1 here, we spectate Hagen. It's a nice mixed dirt map. And like, it's full dirt, yes. But the word mix comes from the fact that it's using the old TMNF dirt blocks, like this one, for example, but also the new dirt blocks, which is really, really cool. So, yeah, no? Very interesting map, and we're gonna hop straight into round number 1, ladies and gentlemen. I think a lot of people didn't play the warm-up now, but it's not that complicated of a map, so it should be fine. We have, of course, a lot of strong players, for example, Brinken. And let's see what people are gonna cook. There's a small cut in the start, look at that! Okay, map 1, and we have a small cut, but is it worth it? I think it's actually not, because the players who cut, I saw Lars and Turbo, for example, doing it, they couldn't quite make the jump, but I will take a look at that in the next round. So let's see what's gonna happen here. Brinken, not with the greatest line here, but he is alive. We have a drop here, smooth landing, very simple map to start with. Also, once again, a reminder, make sure to vote for the maps. You can either type plus plus or minus minus when you are on the server to show what you think about it. And yeah, with that way, we can basically see who built the best map in the ending. So yeah, round 1, really close. Look at this, we have a lot of strong players. Nixobi, Elkon, Tark, Brinken as well. Everybody fighting. It looks like Elkon is going to win the first round, even doing a small flip into the finish to reduce airtime. That is pretty crazy. Holy moly, eh. But I think this is a map nobody can complain about. Like, maybe it's not the greatest map ever, but I think for a first map to start off the month and also the cup, quite solid, I would say. And Tark is saying not Heave on the account. Yeah, hello. I forgot to look at the cut. But apparently you can just, like, straight from the start, you can just jump here. Interesting. I need to remember that for the next round. But look at this. Lars is in first with a small lead. So I think the cut is actually worth it if you execute it nicely. So I need to remember that. I need to remember. We also have a lot of OK boys playing today, actually. We have Turbo, Lars, Chris, Marius, literally almost all of them. So that's pretty cool to see. Of course, I'm the Unparteiischer here. I'm not cheering for anyone specific, but it's of course to see the boys doing good. So yeah, I hope one of them can qualify instantly today. I will explain later on how the qualifying exactly is gonna work, because the Big Egg Monthly Cup, of course, is not only having these weekly qualifiers, it also has a monthly final, which the top 20 players of each month are qualifying to. And that one is basically the main attraction of the month, where also the prize money will be, distributed between the players. So that is basically what everyone is fighting for. And now, I didn't forget about it, let me check out Mr. Lars. Where is he? Here. Let's see if it's actually faster now or if it's not. So they go here, and then rather smooth, going for exit speed, getting a clean landing here, and then with enough speed, also making this somewhat clean. Ah, look at this. Okay. Lars didn't get it optimal, but look at Elkon. Elkon did it, like, perfect, and he's 0.3 or 0.4 ahead of literally everyone else. That is crazy. Okay, I didn't even see this when testing. I basically only did one round on each map to see if the map is drivable, and that is literally it. And maybe checking out the respawns, but I didn't try to look for strategies or something, because I don't want to ruin the surprise for me either. Ah, look at this, man. Elkon is just so good at fast learning specific maps. Like, on some maps, he's, like, really bad, but on, like, some others, he is really, really good. And it seems like this is one of his better ones. He's fighting with Scandio, though, and also Lars with a nice comeback. But it is Elkon in first, Scandio in second, and Lars in third. Actually, three of the most promising players that are participating today, because all three of them, I think, managed to qualify to both of the monthly finals so far. So, some absolute favorites to win it here today. But of course, this was only map one. We have more bangers coming up. And I can tell you, this was probably one of the most normal maps that we will see today. There is definitely some interesting stuff happening later. We have a map which is called Not My First Map. Which is always, whenever there's a map which has something like that in it, it can only be a little bit dang. And I see an AO8 ice downhill. What the frick? Look at this. Ach du Kacke. I'm pretty sure the players will love it, right? Yeah, surely. Maybe an interesting fun fact. The way the warm-up is gonna work is the warm-up has no time limit, timeout. But once the first player finishes the warm-up ends within the next 5 seconds, basically. So that's how it's gonna work. Oh, you can do a wall ride, but then here, very important, players need to dive down in the water. I hope everybody will see that. It's a little bit dank. Yeah, Lars not with the most optimal line, to be fair. Definitely a bit of a harder map. I think this will get a little bit more downwards. Ach du Kacke. And yeah, then here we have the ice downhill. As I said, ice AO8 action going on. Very, very plus plus. People will love it, I'm pretty sure. Gonna be very consistent, for sure, guys. And then we also have, what I also saw in Discovery, we technically have a risky finish. But I never got this to work. I think that risky finish is just a bait. Okay, maybe it's not. Fredwolf somehow made it. But the finish that I just took is like some bobsleigh and then finish jump dingsbums. Definitely a rather dank map, built by Uol. And it seems like people don't like it too much. Okay, round one. This is definitely gonna shuffle the leaderboard around quite a little bit. This is not gonna stay the way it is. I'm pretty sure, because it's very easy to fail here. Elkon with a plus plus, Giga Chat. Elkon with pretty much the only plus plus. So now here, players have to hold break, then going up. And what a beautiful run so far by Elkon. And then here, you need really good timing. Elkon getting it nicely done, but not with the greatest amount of exit speed. But I guess, as long as you survive, it's gonna be fine here. So now the AO8, Elkon with a super smooth line. Oh my god. Oh, but he's gonna miss the checkpoint, isn't he? Is he gonna get in? Yeah, losing a lot of speed. Redwolf trying to go for the risky, Elkon trying as well. But, looking rather dank. The risky is really hard to get because they have wet and icy tires. So I'm not sure if it's that smart to go for them. Fredwolf actually got it, and Fredwolf in fifth. Okay, very hard risky, but it seems somewhat doable. I don't know, a little bit dank. But this is here the normal ending. Maybe Lucas Toby is gonna show it to us. You have bobsleigh into yeet. So yeah, fantastic. Absolutely fantastic track. That's a crazy one. This is a crazy map, eh? Not gonna lie. Not gonna lie. Nah, that was just a meme from earlier, because Tarkuns said earlier that it's not Heath playing for him, but then Elkon said that Heath is playing for him, for Elkon. Anyway, doesn't matter. Let's focus on the rounds, guys. It was just a joke. Oh no, Lucas Toby with the roof hit and the flip and not getting it. But look at this, Fatty Vest is getting a good line. Going for a bit of a safer approach on this one. Oh, look at this. You have a smooth line on the right. Maybe actually worth it if you get it down really good. It looks a bit bouncy from Fatty Vest. But I guess if you get it really good, it might work out. Let's see. Do we have people on the risky finish? Yes, Lars. Look at this. Lars. And Lars is gonna... Oh, second. Holy moly. 6,000 behind Dennis. But that... Like, if you get the risky finish good and first try... It is actually worth it, because the bobsleigh is quite a longer route. And if you get the bobsleigh jump bad, you also jump like really high and lose a lot of time. So holy moly, eh. So it's a very risky finish. It's always kind of funny if it's like risky finishes in Trackmania are usually never too risky. They're just like slightly more difficult, but not really risky. But this one surely is, especially because of this entry. Because you have wet tires, icy tires, and you have like a bounce. As you can see, it's super hard to control. But yeah, interesting map. But yeah, we have one more round here, I think. So let's see what's gonna happen. Oh, Brimken with a brilliant start. Oh, look at this. Jan went for a water bounce. Interesting line as well. Oh, no turbo. Starting the backslide too early. Full depth because of that. We also have Plisky playing again. Also one of the players who qualify. Oh, oh my god, he's going full risk. But that's not worth it at all. He is not getting the checkpoint. Fatty Vest once again going for his risky line. Let's see if it's gonna work out better. But look at this, Nisivo is getting it really good. Fatty Vest doing some crazy flips, and it's Elkon in first right now. Going for the safe finish though, so he might get sniped. Oh, but Elkon also with a super high jump. That is not good. Is he getting overtaken? No, actually not. Even though he is jumping to the fucking space station, he is still winning the round. Maybe now the time has come to explain you a little bit more how the ending of this tournament is going to look like. Because as I said, once players reach the finalist mode at 6,969 points, they need to win one more round in order to close out the match. And winning one specific round against 106 other players, who are mostly actually really good players, is extremely difficult. So closing out finalist is a challenge and a half, that's for sure. In the meantime, we have the next map. Look at this. Find the Fastest Way 7 by Enno Popeno. And if this is not a banger map, then I don't freaking know. Look at this masterpiece. We have 1, 2, 3, 4 checkpoints. And probably a million, quasillion, trillion car switch gates. And players basically need to find the fastest route. So that's gonna be interesting for sure. Everybody with the minus minus. Literally everybody with the minus minus. That's interesting. But yeah, guys, get the checkpoints. Now there is 4 checkpoints. You can see them in camera 7. So make sure to check them out. I think the fastest way, honestly, is just to like get this, drive to this, drive to this, drive to this. I don't really think there is much more to it. Like, you just get the checkpoints and then, yeah, the cars are, you can kind of ignore the cars, to be honest. Well, that's gonna be interesting. I think we should maybe spectate it in camera 7 from top, because I think people will use different routes here, and I want to see what's the fastest. So, do we have different checkpoint orders first of all? Yes, some people going left, some others are going this one first, but this one seems to be the most prominent one. Then going to the left here. Oh my god, that's so chaotic. You don't see anything. But I think this here is the main field. Last checkpoint, and now into the finish, and it is Valegen with the first round win. 22.4 seems like a very strong time. Honestly, a cool map. And probably also the map that I'm going to use for the thumbnail. Banger map, if you ask me. And look at this, we have now in first place. Interesting. But let's maybe spectate Valegen, because he was the winner of the previous round, and I want to see his route. So, diagonal in the start. Snow car here. Car switch, car switch, car switch. Snow car, instant steering, snow car... Snow car, instant steering, snow car. You definitely want to use the snow car for the turns. Then here, quick stadium car part. Checkpoint, checkpoint, checkpoint. Now ready car, dangerous. Can slide out and into the right. And Valegen in 6th place. But this time we also have a 22.4 winning time by now. And look at this. Now, arguably not one of the absolute favorites in this tournament when you have people like Elkon, Lois, Valegan, Skandir, etc. And also Marius. But now actually cooking, having a little bit of a point lead. And it's really cool to see that we don't have like one or two players absolutely dominating. It's always different players in first. Like, I think this is literally the most stacked edition ever of the Big Yak Monthly Cup. Might be because of the special maps that we have this month, but might also be because we have a 400 euro prize pool this month. So no goodies or no merch to win, literally only money. And money is of course always nice. So definitely a lot of people want to have a shot at winning that. So yeah, really cool to see. We have one more round here. And while that round is going, a quick reminder that, as I said earlier, we have Finders mode later. And we're going to play the top 5 people. So the tournament is going to go on up until 5 people won a finalist round, basically. And as I said earlier, people are trying to qualify for the monthly final. And the way it works is that the top 3 today will instantly qualify to the monthly final. They will instantly qualify. They don't have to play any of the other qualifiers. They are just straight up in. And then 4th place will win points towards the leaderboard. Actually, a lot of points. 15,000. 5th place is going to win 10,000 points towards the leaderboard. And then all of the other players are going to win the points that they had once the tournament ended. So basically, if Brinken closes out, or like if Brinken has, like, let's say 4,000 points when the tournament ends, those 4,000 points he will get onto the leaderboard. And yeah, right now, it's absolutely impossible to call who it's going to be. But it's possible to call what the next map is, because it is Go Big or Go Home by FV Buki. And my prediction is that this is actually the best map of today. I would say this is, driving-wise, the best map of today. And I think everybody will like it. It's like one of these typical good Bonk Cup maps, kind of. It's a really good one. So let's see what Lars will do in the warm-up. Let's see. So we start off with a turbo kind of drop into a quarter pipe jump to the right. Then following the arrows into the checkpoint here. A left turn. Then going down small, roof it into a bobsleigh turn. Out of the bobsleigh, down the grass hill, wanna keep grip. We have a small desert car part, so I guess Elkon will go with the minus minus. And then we have a backslide setup with desert car into stadium car. Very dank, but it works pretty nicely if you have a feeling for it. Then you have a backslide, of course, a drop, and then you bounce up, get the plastic bounce with reactor, and into the finish. IMO, a really cool map. Banger map, if you ask me. I guess people will vote a little bit of minus minus. Well, Elkon voting minus minus because of Bob and not because of Desert Car. Really mad. But a cool map here, in my opinion. Really cooked. Very nice and fun, if you ask me. So let's see. Oh, Lars going way too far outside, going over the spinner. Lars. Ay. Okay, Lars with a really bad round. Let's follow Austrian Alt. So far, so good for him. 35th place. He is in the middle of the field. Ah, but sliding out with Desert Car. And now he will have less speed into the backslide. Can he still set it up somehow? Yes, and actually getting a really nice inside line. But of course, with no exit speed. So not the greatest round by him. But it is still a 31st place. Nothing to be worried about. Pretty solid. In the meantime, we have Elkon winning once again. That is crazy, actually. Elkon once again with a round win. But I feel like Elkon is either winning the rounds or he is like 50th and fully failing. Holy moly, eh. But cool map if you ask me. Like, this one deserves some good votes, guys, right? This one deserves some good votes. Come on. We are somewhat getting closer to the second half of the match. People are now halfway through for the point limit. Once again, a reminder, it's 6,969. And look at this, Marius also doing really good this edition. And Marius actually was a little bit of an upset last month because he did not manage to qualify to the monthly final. Barely. It was really close, but sadly, he couldn't play one of the qualifiers properly. So he sadly didn't have enough points. And he also didn't get top 3 in any of the qualifiers. So maybe this time, it's the first time Marius can actually instantly qualify. Would be really cool because Marius is, of course, good at fast learning. He plays a lot of tournaments. So he has a lot of experience. But on the other hand, Marius is not the fastest player. He's consistent, but not the fastest player. And in the ending, for closing out finalist mode, you just need to have pace. You need to win one round where you're faster than everybody else. So it will be interesting to follow Marius on his journey here. This round, getting fourth place, that is some solid points for him again. Closing up a little bit to now. And Elkon, so far, the only one who managed to drive a sub 32 times. So I want to see if he's doing anything special, because I didn't really pay attention to the fastest players on this map yet. So, of course, first quarter pipe jump, reduce airtime. Doing it really nicely. Small Neo slide to get a better setup here. Okay, Giga Chat. And then going for a very nice bobsleigh line. Look at this. Nobody has it as good as him. Never mind. Actually, Brinken and Scandio had it really good. Then, old car. Elkon, keyboard player. And even he is not sliding out. So, no. Keyboard is not the issue, guys. Oh, and... No, oh my god, he got such a good exit. Hit the pole, though. Is it still first? Yeah, look at this. Still first place, even though he crashed. The thing is, Elkon did something really smart. Maybe small tutorial time for you guys. When you have bug slides, you guys maybe notice that whenever you do this counter steer in order to like close out or exit the bug slide, you lose a lot of speed. But when you do it right in front of a jump like this and you do most of the rotation in the air, you keep a lot more speed, and that's what Elkon did. He had so much more speed, and if he wouldn't have crashed the pole, he would have been so much faster. So small Peppo G for you guys. The best way to drive this was basically to prolong this backslide until the edge, do the cancel of the backslide very late, and then have the rotation in the air. So maybe for you guys as a small reminder, in case you ever have a situation like that again. Peppo G, yeah, Elkon, now you know. And now, ladies and gentlemen, can I get a Blah in the chat, please? We have a map which is called Blah is the bane of my existence and I can't escape it, in brackets, Blah. And this map is built by objectively the worst mapper in the game. Patrice, the man, the myth, the legend, put a map into the BYMC. I got kicked from my own server. That is always great. I tried to join as a spectator. Okay, now I missed the entire warm-up, guys. Fuck. Man. Really mad. Anyway, we are here. But we have Blah. We have a huge fucking Joel. We have 10 million finishes. And we have a really bad map. So let's just hop straight into it. We have full speed bobsleigh now. Peng, Patrice with an absolute banger here. Full speed bobsleigh into drop here. Landing into water. The map is easy, though. Like, Patrice did follow the rules. The map is absolute dog shit, but it follows the rules. Then we have a way too slow dirt uphill into dirt left turn. Then you have a pipe entry, which is super shit, where you have to go onto the side. And then you have a 1 million speed flip, which always puts you into the lowest ring. Like, you cannot not hit the lowest ring. I don't even know, like, why is there even 10 million rings here, Patrice? If you can only... Look, everybody goes here. Nobody goes even in the second highest one. The map is absolutely shit. What is this here, by the way? Blah? Wait, who's this little bro? Wait, look at this! There's a Pac-Man! Holy shit! Okay, that's wicked. There's a fucking Pac-Man. Easter egg hunt, fuck the rounds, nobody wants to see the gameplay. I wanna see the Easter eggs. Oh, nice, we also have a GPS. With an angel. Mashallah, what a map by Patrice here. Absolute banger map. Very great. Wait, Sampler! Why is Sampler so far ahead? What did Sampler do? What the fuck? Dude, Sampler was so far ahead. Did you see that? That's crazy. He's 1.3 seconds ahead. What is he doing in the start? What the hell? Okay, I need to spectate him next round. He found some way to dodge the water, I guess. Now also going really safe. Marius would be proud. And zack, yeet. Bumper is working. And finish. And really good time by him. Holy moly, Sampler. Oppa. Yeah. That's actually a nice time. Almost 2 seconds ahead of second. What the hell? That's crazy. Anyway, Sampler with really good points here. And I'm going to spectate him now. Mr. Sampler, please show me what you're doing. Okay, this time it didn't work apparently. Okay, no idea what he did, but he was extremely fast around before. No freaking clue. But this round also really unfortunate drop. That's not good. But look at this. Lucas Turbo with a good round this time. Not with the greatest gears up the dings, but if he gets the pipe entry nice, I think he, we got really good points, and he's getting it really good. Is getting overtaken by one or two players, but, oh, look at this, what a close race we have. Dude, look at this, Turbo, Seamouse, and the other guy were so close to each other. Jesus Christ, what the hell? Look at this, Purple with a 29.9. Okay, I have no idea how this map works, but absolute banger. Patrice, thank you very much for sending in your map. Banger. Literally a freaking banger, guys. Ay, ay, ay. Next map is called Free Up by Ganove. And this, I think... Yeah, this was a more proper map again. With some, you know, cool things. And nothing too bad. Warm up. Let's follow Lars again. Lars is my personal GPS. Yeah, true. Mario's, of course, lost a little bit of points. That's not so good. But it's all good, guys. So let's follow Lars. We have a small dirt part instantly to the right. Good job, Lars. Let's follow Lucas Turbo. Then we have a jump to the left, where you can land quite smooth. Don't want to bounce as much. Want to keep the speed into this quarter pipe jump. Very good warm-up by Lucas Turbo, actually. A right turn, ping. Oh, look at this! Turbo in first place in the warm-up. Getting speed into the looping. Surviving it. Now the right turn. Now we have a jump. And then you have a risky finish up there, which you can flip into. If you don't make it, there is a safe finish around the corner, basically. So yeah, pretty cool map, I think. Nothing too crazy, but pretty drivable and nice to learn. Yes, Intax, it is too late. But you can maybe save up the map for, in case I will do this again in one of the next months. Because I think I will. But for now, it is too late, sadly. So come on, Marius. The man who wants to qualify today. Yeah, exactly, Intax, exactly. Start is looking good by Marius. Has good speed, also got the upper gear. But look at this, he is only in like 18th place. And 18th is, of course, solid. But you don't get really good points from that. 16th now, he might also catch Jan, barely. He is also getting a good finish, but it is only 14th in the ending. Nonetheless, solid points here, 280. But as you can see, players ahead of him are scoring more. Elkon with a win. It's a typical Elkon map, to be honest. Elkon with good points here. With that, is he... Yeah, he is overtaking now. And Skandir also losing out a little bit. So it is still really, really close, guys. And finalist mode is coming closer and closer. And it's just crazy, to be honest. It is just crazy how close of a fight we're gonna have here. Next round, round number two. What about Verlegen? Verlegen was really good in the beginning of the cup, but then also lost out a little bit. But Verlegen also rather the type of guy to be good on normal maps like this. So let's see how he's gonna do. Not with the greatest drift, not with the greatest exit speed, but still in the top field here. Let's see, the quarterpipe jump is very decisive. You wanna keep as much speed as possible, and Verlegen seems like he got it really, really good. Currently in fifth place, fighting against Marius, actually. Oh, Verlegen got the gear and the others didn't. Look at this, Verlegen pushing ahead of the others. He's fighting against Marius. Oh, Verlegen with a bad line. Is he gonna get the risky finish even? Oh, Verlegen! Oh, barely getting in. He still got sixth place. That was really lucky. That could have gone very, very wrong. That was actually really close. Holy moly, eh. So, let's see. Verlegen with a bit of a no-slide strat. Interesting. And this time getting a really good drift. So much exit speed. Small side jump, but landing very far right. And look at this. Elkon had a bit of a better line and therefore has a lot more speed. Is Elkon actually going to do the perfect? Is he going to win another round? Looking close this round. Fighting against Skandir. Verlegen also still up there. But it looks like Skandir is going to win this round. Not entirely sure though. Depends. And Skandir jumping too low! No, Skandir! Nah, Skandir missed the finish. Ain't no way, little bro. He could have just saved. Ay, 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 ay. Frigate Circuit by Sneaky is coming up now. This one is a little bit like narrow, tight-ish, with a lot of fog, as you can see. What the fog? Oh, look, it's actually snowing. Look at this. You see the particles flying through. But this is a rather simple map, to be honest. Frigid. My bad. But this is a rather simple map. You go into the first dirt here. Little bit of a U-turn. Then jump out here. Bit of a speed check. But if you have to respawn here, you can go far left. So it's respawnable. Then right turn. Keep the speed. Jump back into the dirt. Small zigzagoo here. And then only a right turn into the finish. Actually, very simple map. So, Lars, I'm super sorry. This is actually quite a simple one. But I'm pretty sure the next one is going to be more dank again. And, I mean, on this map, we could possibly see our first winner. But we will see. Let's follow Elkon. Elkon needs... Okay, Elkon cannot get finalist yet. But he could get it super soon. Elkon with a nice inside line. Jumping into left turn. Ah, not with the greatest entry here. Has to steer a lot on the dirt. But, of course, keeping a lot of speed. Thing is, the speed doesn't really help him. Because we have a tight turn. Now, not getting the cleanest jump either. But still in fourth place at the moment. Oh, but touching! Is he gonna make the jump? Is he gonna make it? Oh, yo, 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 yo. And he's going up the hill with 10 kilometers an hour. And with that, only 58th. Holy shit, that small touch cost Elkon 50 positions. And that's actually really bad because he only got 90 points now. And that means he needs to get quite a good next round in order to get finalist. Elkon needs a top 3 to get finalist, if my maths are correct. So let's see. I'm pretty sure he's not gonna fail again, but is it gonna be enough for the top 3? The map is indeed simple. So it could literally be anyone getting a good round here. But look at this. Elkon looking juicy. Only Brinken ahead, but Elkon does not need first. If it's second, it's fine. Oh, and Elkon is getting it. What a clutch by Elkon. Winning 460 points. And with that, we have our first finalist player, ladies and gentlemen. Elkon now in finalist mode, which means he needs to win one more round against everyone else in order to qualify. And if he pulls that off, he is qualified for the monthly final already. That's crazy. Will Elkon pull it off or will he get denied? In the meantime, Skandir is now in the position to potentially get into finalist mode as well. So that's going to be interesting too. But I feel like Brinken is the only one who can deny Elkon at this point. And this round looks exactly like that. Oh, Elkon kept the gear. I think it's GG. Elkon kept the gear. That's so good. And Elkon closing it out instantly. That is crazy. Elkon kept the upper gear and instantly winning it. And with that, Elkon is qualified to the monthly final. Elkon is so good at this, man. That's so boring. I wish he would have lost. I would have wanted some more exciting finalist shit. But crazy, man. Really good performance by Elkon. Really sick that he kept the gear in this one dirt point. That was the reason why he won, to be honest. 0.6 is really fast. Not quite the offer time, actually. But yeah, really good time. And now we have a dank map. This one is dank by Spaney. This is what Lars wanted. So in the beginning, we have wood with a lot of speed. Peng, 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 peng. You can do wood wiggles if you want to. Then you have a flip. You can also just go press forward. If you survive the flip, you have an ice slide with poles, because why the fuck not? Then here, get reactor down. Make sure to get reactor down. So, peng. Then you have a reactor down wall. Have to go into the checkpoint. Have to go up as well. Very tricky to get this, actually. Not easy. And then when you are at the ending, you jump out at the top. And then we have an AO8 snow downhill with trees. If that's not a proper map, I don't know. Absolute banger. If this is not a plus plus plus, then I don't know. This is such a banger map. Shoutouts to Spaney. Also, the name of the map, the mama at the end of the tunnel. That's a banger. The mama. Because you bang here. You bang the wall. That's why it's the mama. Bang. You know? Mama. So let's see. who's gonna be fast on this? I think if you just survive this, you're gonna be fine. But of course, the ending is full luck. We also have a plastic bounce here. I didn't even notice. Oh, but turbo fully bonking the things. The respawn is also very punishing here. I don't know. Where is the lead going? Holy shit. We have people dropping. Lars looking good. Chris also looking good. Cheese lover very close, but on his roof. Who's going to win the round? It is Combo. CJ Lars coming in as well. Absolute chaos. I freaking love it. Plus, plus. The final people finishing, Sampler barely making it, Thomas making it, and yeah, a lot of DNFs, holy moly. But we have another finalist, it is Skandir, but in the meantime, we also have at least 5 more people who could get finalist now. So actually a crazy fight. Skandir also going for the PF strat, it's the most consistent, you just have to cancel your steering basically. Now the ice slide. Skandir not really doing a proper ice slide, but it's working. The thing is, oh, Skandir with the hit. Skandir is in the mud. He hit the back of his things. Let's follow Lucas Tobi. This is how it looks like when you jump out. And Lucas Tobi hitting the one tree that is in the way. Banger. Lucas Tobi, that's my man. Hitting the one tree that is in the way. Fantastic. Cinema. Ladies and gentlemen, cinema. There is one tree that you can instantly hit and Turbo managed to hit it. Banger. Absolute banger. Okay, final round on this map. It is a banger of a map. Let's see what's gonna happen. Brinken actually not going for the PF. And getting a really good start. Can't complain too much about it. He's actually going for an ice slide line, but he has to open the steering. Now going up and going down. Valegen and Skandir are cooking. Let me spectate Skandir. Skandir jumping down, jumping crazy. No, he hit a tree. He hit a tree. Who's gonna win? Who's gonna win? Who's gonna win? Brinken? Is Brinken finalist? Brinken is finalist, but Brinken is on his side and it's the lead sniping. Ain't no way. Brinken had it so good, but he had such an unfortunate landing. Oh, hell nah. But now the finalist fiesta is slowly but surely gonna begin. We have 5 finalists now, and we go over to the next map. And the next map is called Perp Skirp by NBK. And this is actually a multilab. We have a multilab block here. Where is it? Here. We have a multilab. And there is one interesting thing about this map, which is that for lab 2, you have Snowcar. You have Snowcar, which you get... where do you even get it? Here. You get Snowcar here, but you can also go and get Stadium Car back in lab 2. So it's a little bit of... You need to figure out what's the fastest. And I can tell you there is one clear fastest way to go for, but I'm not gonna tell you what it is. Haha. You guys have to figure that out yourself. So let's see. But yeah, very simple map. On this one of the really fast players could definitely close it out here. So let's see. Going inside here, then we have a little bit of free blocking, then a free wheel... Transition landing in the wall right. Then here you can go through the triangle of the checkpoint. Not too easy to do, but also not too risky. Then we have penalty grass here, and people can go for a little bit of airtime here to skip the penalty grass. But then you have way too much speed, so it's hard to control. Then here a little bit of snow car. But then here you can get the stadium car back. If you think it's faster. I don't know. Maybe it is, maybe it's not. So it's gonna be interesting to see what the top players are gonna go for. And if it's worth it or not. I have no idea. I mean, I know, but I'm not gonna tell. So we will see. As you can see, you get really slow towards the ending with Snowcar at least. But yeah, tricky. Tricky map. Let's see what's gonna happen. Brinken with a really good time. So let's maybe follow him. Let's see what he's gonna do. Stadium is 100% faster. Maybe. Let's see what Brinken is gonna do. And then we have proof. So Brinken is finalist. Might be a good chance for him to win. Actually, I think the first time that Brinken joined, Brinken also going for a little bit of airtime extra, and with that getting more speed. No airtime here. Brinken is also good with the other cars, actually. Getting it good. He is going for the stadium car, but he is being chased by the others. Is he gonna survive it? He's keeping grip in the wall, right? Plisky with a different line. But Brinken with no airtime. Jumping really far here. Can he control it? Can he hold his nerves? Plisky is close, but I think it is the GG to Brinken. We had a close fight between him and Plisky, but I think now it is safe to say that, yeah, Stadium Car only is actually faster. yeah, Brinken with that, the second person to instantly qualify to the monthly final. Nice. GG to Brinken. With that, we only have one slot left, one player left who can instantly qualify. Next round, Plisky. Was really good, but Plisky is only 22nd right now. Not the greatest addition by Plisky. So let's see if he is gonna survive it or not. This is gonna be interesting. Plisky was by far the second fastest. Does he know about the extra airtime? Yes, he does. Plisky is smart. Getting a good line here. Getting really good speed into the snow car. Is he gonna survive the snow car? Yes, looking good. Going for the stadium car now. Is he being chased by anyone? He has a 0.2 gap to Croxy. So if he survives, I think he is gonna make it. And he's gonna deny all of the finalists. So let's see if he's gonna survive it. Going for a lot of airtime here. Getting it really fast. 0.5 ahead of second. Getting it. Ay, 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 he's making it. Okay. Plisky with the big boy deny. Denying multiple finalists. And yeah, as you can see in the meantime, we have more and more finalists and more people getting close. Purple now joining the finalists as well. Barely though. But yeah, Plisky actually denying all of the gamers. And with that, we only have one round left on this map. So let's see what's gonna happen. So, the thing is, Marius should also be good on this, no? But I guess he's struggling with the stadium car points. The thing is, there's only like this one snow car chicane. But it is quite important to keep a lot of speed through it. Marius also going for very interesting lines. Is that worth it to go like this? I'm not sure. But also going for a lot of airtime here. A lot of airtime here. That's good, of course. Yeah, Marius. Yeah, Marius is finalist. Reminder. Marius could close it out. But who is he battling against? It is Lars. But also Heath and Marijn as well. What a close round now. Who's gonna make it? I have no idea. Heath with a very different line, having low speed. Marius could close it out with a big boy jump. Is he gonna make it? But Machrein has it really good. Machrein with a bad line, but Heath more inside. Who's gonna win it? Oh my god, it's Heath. But Heath was not finalist. What is happening? Marius getting denied by 0.1 because he had a bad entry. Oh my god, man. What a round this was. That was the best chance Marius might have for this cup. And now we go over to the next map. What is the next map going to be? It is PF at some point by Kodik. And I think this is a good map for Lars. Because the idea of this map basically is that you have a lot of risky routes. Or like sort of risky routes. For example, here you can go left. Small precision part, but you get a booster. Then here, same thing. You can get this booster on the outside, but you have to risk it to the edge. Then here, you have this plastic bounce you can go for, which puts you up into this pool. Wait, nobody sees it. I saw it first try in this qualifying. Interesting. Nobody saw it. Okay, I'm not sure if it's faster though. I have no idea. Then also in the ending, you have a little bit of a risky jump here, which is not really risky. And then to close it out, also a little bit of a, dingsbums. And also actually one thing that you can go for is this reactor here. With this reactor, you get a lot more speed for the ending and get the risky finish. So a lot of different things to discover on this map. And it's going to be interesting to see who gets the strats the best. And especially if this plastic bounce is faster, because you skip the slow-mo, but you often land backwards. So it's not like super nice. But let's see. Okay, some people are going for it. Here they come. Here they come. Oh, but it's not faster, I think. It looks slower. It's Heath in first now. Is Heath finalist? Heath is not finalist yet. Is he gonna go for the reactor? Yes, he is. Everybody does. Going for the speed. Going for the jump. Is he gonna make it clean to the finish? Yes. Heath with the first place. And with that, Heath is in finalist. Same for Marintje, also in finalist. Same for Arpa. So we have like, 9 finalists now. That's crazy. Wait, you can skip the slow-mo? Or what? Ach nee. You can skip the slow-mo. Yeah, hello. Yeah, okay. That's interesting then. You can skip the slow-mo. Oh, look at this. They're also not going for the booster here. So you go here, keep grip. Ach so. Okay. Now I see. So there is like multiple risky strats. Oh, but is Heath gonna win the round? CJ is in first. CJ is not finalist. CJ could deny, but CJ with a bad landing. It's now Plisky. Plisky is also not finalist. Who's gonna win the round? Is Plisky gonna win it? And Plisky denying Marintje and Heath. That's so crazy, man. What is happening? We have more and more players getting into finalist and nobody closing it out. That's insane, man. That's crazy. So many finalists now. It's like 10 or 11 or something. Holy moly. Okay, what's gonna happen? What is gonna happen? Also, what is the scenery, by the way? It looks like... why do these towers all have these... it looks so yuck. Either way, let's see what's gonna happen. Lucas Toby with a good start. Lucas Toby with a good drift. Lucas Toby with a good dodge. But he's not in first. Who is in first, though? It's hard to tell. It is Valegen. Valegen is finalist. Valegen with a touch. Marein now. Marein with a good line. But he is fighting against some others. Is he gonna get the lowest reactor? He is fighting against Kush. Who is gonna get it? Marein is winning it. Oh my god. Marein with the clutch. GG, Marein to qualifying to the monthly final. And dude, Marein is really like... Marein is honestly really an impressive player when it comes to Fastlane tournaments. He's getting better and better at them. Like, look at the players he beat. Like, he beat Heath, Marius, Now, CJ, Valegen, Scandio, Nixobi, Lars. He beat so many good players. That's crazy. So, yeah, well played to Marein. One of the Dutchies, one of the many Dutchies who are always playing my tournaments, making it here. That is cool to see. But first of all, we're gonna go to the next map. And it is called BYMC Spiders Everywhere by Spidermax, who's also in the chat. Spidermax, it's your map. And this one is a little bit tricky. Small help. Actually, after wood, jump out to the reactors and go up right. Small help, because I found that a bit confusing. Because you can basically go here, but you have to go there later. You have to jump out here. Yeah, don't go there, go here. That's what I said. Go here. Go here, go up, and then you have two checkpoints here. It's a little bit confusing, to be honest. So, not optimal signage here, Mr. Spider-Max. But it works. Then here, you have to go and use these pipes, or like this pipe, to jump in here, survive this, go here, quarter pipe, jump up, plastic wall ride, and risky finish with a bounce here, which is hopefully consistent, but it should be. It's a little bit confusing. I hope people have figured it out. I'm gonna check in Camp 7, but I think so many people missed it. I tried to help. I'm sorry. Your tip was more confusing? What do you mean? Okay, many are getting it, but many are also not getting it. Here we have the players who got it. And it's Heath. Heath looking really good. Oh, look. Some are also going the other way around. But Heath in first. Ah, but Heath is not aware. You need to take the bump. And I think it's Sentrian in first now. These are the leaders right now. Sentrian in first. Sentrian is not finest, I think. Heath forgot about the beam. I think... Yeah, all of them are clueless. Oh, no. I think it's still Sentrian in first. I think Sentrian should be the first finisher. It's so confusing, to be honest. Sentrian getting the bounce. And yes, it's Sentrian in first. Lucas Turbo in second. And Profit in third. That's crazy. Yeah, it's true. Like, you can water bounce directly into this checkpoint and turn around. But then you have wet tires, of course. So I think it's not better to do. But yeah, tricky map. Very... I need an Evo after this. Yeah, it's tricky, guys. I tried to help. I'm sorry if my help was shit. I tried to help. But you need to go here and then jump out and backslide up. It's a bit confusing. It's a bit confusing. It's a bit confusing. People not reading chat. Yeah. But of course, with this, Sentrian finalist. Oh, Sentrian finalist. He could clutch it up. Look how many finalists we have. Okay, I need to follow in Camp 7 again. Otherwise, I'm completely confused. Spider-Max forgot his own map. Yeah. So, who is getting it? Who is aware? Okay, most are aware, but not everyone. Going up, and it's Austrian. Austrian is not finest, I think. But he is not that far in the lead. And it's now. Now fighting. Now is fighting for the victory. Austrian failing the beam a little bit. Clipping. Oh, but also Blef is fighting. Blef is fighting. Seemaus also here. But it's still Austrian holding up. Austrian actually cooking. Is Austrian finalist? No, he's not. But Austrian clipped. He's fighting against Blef. But Blef is... Is Austrian winning? Oh, no. Oh, okay, he made it actually. Holy shit. That was such a weird round. Austrian barely managed to keep it up with a good start. And with that, winning the round and getting a good amount of points. Where is he even? He's in 31st and he won the round. That's crazy, actually. That is actually crazy. Holy moly, eh. Come on, guys. We need a winner. Come on. There's still two finalist modes being played out. We definitely will go to the next map as well. Come on, guys. Focus. We have like 15 finalists. There's just one of them who needs to win. Oh, Sentrian with a good backslide. Sentrian, but also Croxy. Croxy is not finest yet, though. Sentrian. We also have Varys, but Varys is also not finest. Sentrian could close it out. Ah, Sentrian clipping. What is this? Holy moly, that was so scary. Getting the water. Oh, did he get wet tires? I hope not. No, he got wet tires. In no way, little bro. He threw it. Quarter pipe. He gets it really clean. Is Sentrian gonna win it? Is he staying in first? Someone has more speed. He needs a good bounce. Sentrian. And Sentrian has it. Getting fourth place. GG to Sentrian. Not instantly qualifying to the monthly final, but Sentrian is winning 15,000 points, which is a lot. So with these 15,000 points, if he just does good in the other qualifiers, he will be qualified. So GG to Sentrian. Well played, my friend. Very good. Very good. Very good. And Turbo also top three in all rounds. Ain't no way. And Turbo also finalist. Ah, that's so unlucky, Turbo. Holy moly, eh. That is actually unlucky. Scheiße. Unluckers Turbo. But as I said, Sentrian, 15,000 points towards the leaderboard. Fifth place, which we still have to play out, is going to win 10,000 points. Then all of the people who are in finalist will win, I think, 8,000 points or 8,500. I'm not even sure. No, 7,500. 7.5k. Oh my god. Okay, this map is bad. This map, honestly, BYMC Canyon Ride by K-Vampe. This map is not so good, I gotta say it. This map is a little bit yuck. But yeah, all finalists will win 7,500 points, my bad. And all of the other players will just win the points that they had when the match ended. So, as I said, the 15,000 points are quite important. And they are almost worth as much as an instant qualify. So we have a hold drop where you can release. Then we have bobsleigh. And then we have a no steer into this. And this one is going to decide everything. We have no steer. And if you keep enough speed and land clean here, you can get past the anti-boost, go up and finish. Very dank. Not easy to get at all. This is going to be interesting. This is going to be very, very interesting. It's basically do or die. You need to full send it. You need to full send the nose there. So let's see who is going to have the most speed. Who is going to get it the best? There is many possible winners. CJ. CJ Bonking. Kihir. Kihir. Is Kihir going to survive? Kihir has low speed. Who is going to make it? Nixorby. It is Nixorby. And Nixorby is closing it out. He was finalist. GG to Nixorby. Getting fifth place. Winning 10,000 points. He was willing to take the risk and he did close it out in the ending. What a stacked match this was, guys. Holy moly. So many great players who actually didn't close it out. Like, also the first time I think that Lars was not in the top 5. Marius Nieder, so many finalists. Absolutely crazy. Absolutely crazy stuff here by the players. Thank you very much to everybody who joined. Thank you very much to the players who sent in the maps, of course. But yeah, for the people who didn't manage to close it out today, of course, we will be back next month. Next Monday, of course, same time, 20 CEST. We're going to have the next edition where, once again, three players can instantly qualify, where you guys can once again win points.